Mile in a minute.
Welcome back to the channel. Another episode of Riding and Rambling. Back on the old Dyna girl here. Had a few updates throughout the summertime. The crank bearing, I switched over to a lefty Tipkin style crank bearing, and that thing went kaboom. Well, we had the bottom end rebuilt, and after that, while it was all taken apart, I went ahead and had the shop send out my transmission to Mike at A1 Cycles. Had that thing rebuilt and the dog's back cut and everything. And she does shift like butter now, baby, let me tell you. But also, yeah, while they were putting everything back together, I had them go ahead and do some ARP bolts from BAMCO. And that was pretty cool. It wasn't just kind of order, get them and throw them on. There were a couple little bumps. A few things like my highway pegs, because they're a little bit farther out. I needed a little extra longer bolt there. And then the other one that was tricky was, my exhaust bracket bolt. My exhaust bracket, where your exhaust bracket bolts up to your transmission case, it's probably gonna be different for everybody. So you might even want to, if you're getting the full kit, the full Dyna kit, hit up BAMCO and maybe take those bolts out first and measure the ones that go in through the bracket, because you'll need different sizes for those. But yeah, this video might look different. We're a little bit past my first year of doing YouTube videos. So I started thinking to myself, man, it's time to complete my promise. As I said in the beginning of when I started this, each video I'm trying something new, and I have been doing that, even if you guys might not be noticing it. As small as the changes are, a lot of times it takes me fucking hours to get that stuff done. But the new changes I want to try, and I don't know if I'll continue to implement them, but for now, right now, my GoPro is set to 1/160th with 30 frames, and ISO at 100, max 800, auto white balance, and then we're running with the bigger shutter speed, I guess, we're running an ND filter. Right now, because the sun's down, I'm using an ND16. We're gonna try that out. And also, I'm doing it in, I don't know, like the sharpness all the way down to low, and then the GoPro color at flat. So I just wanna practice my hand in color grading. See if I can make this stuff right here look way cooler. And we won't really know until I try, you know? So that's pretty cool. I haven't really been on this bike in a while. I've been riding the Road Glide, as you guys saw in the last video. We rode out to Yellowstone, Grand Tetons, Beartooth. Well, I don't even know at this point if it was the last video, because after that we also did Escalante, the Blakline Speed Shop ride out, and that was sick. Working on all these videos has been a lot of fun. It's definitely a challenge though, for sure, you know? Definitely a challenge for me, but I love challenges and I love the process. Turn down my music so you guys can't hear it. Running this Lexan Novus and the music's always so loud and crystal clear that my mic can pick it up and it'll show a copyright claim on my YouTube videos. So gotta be careful there. Anyways, yeah, I don't really know too much about what we're gonna be riding to in the winter. I would like to definitely practice more, kind of like getting used to and getting better at my different cameras that I have. The DJI Osmo 3 is a really fun camera to use, but I feel like when I use it, I'm just lost because I'm a caveman when it comes to all this stuff. But yeah, anyways, right now we're going to go meet up with my friend Tony, and I guess he said he left some keys at the auto place, so gonna meet up with him, ride around for a little bit. It's 40 degrees, and as the sun goes down, it just feels colder and colder, and I don't really have the proper gear on right now for for riding. Soon I'll put on my winter riding gear. I'll put that up as a video to kind of let you guys know what I use when I ride in the winter and how I get to riding through a place that fucking snows all year, how I'm riding in 30 or less degree weather comfortably. So I'll put one of those videos up for you guys. You don't have to ride in those temperatures, but it might give you guys some like kind of insight onto what you might want to wear if you're riding in cold weather. But yeah, anyways, I'm gonna get going. Go head out, meet up with this guy, and I don't want this thing to be too long, so we'll let you guys go. Hopefully this video turned out cool. Like this sunset right here that you can kind of, well, sunset's actually on the outside, but the color is coming off the sunset on the mountains there with the snow on the tips. Hopefully you guys can kind of see that, and it looks pretty cool with the color grading I'm gonna be getting into. If not, I don't know, maybe we'll go back to regular GoPro color and put everything on auto. But yeah, all right guys, hope you guys are having a good one, man, and we'll see you on the next one.